Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you four ways you can use the luminance levels in your video clips to create four different Luma Fade transitions. The first couple methods are nice and simple, actually using the cross dissolve transition built right into Final Cut Pro. First, to demonstrate this, let me show you this transition on two gradient clips. First one with white on top and black on the bottom, and the second clip with black on top and white on the bottom. When you add a cross dissolve transition to your clips, the dissolve is linear, with the first clip fading out and the next clip fading in all at the same time. Now, if we select the transition clip in the timeline, up in the inspector window, we can modify the look of this cross dissolve. For the first method, from the look menu, select shadows. What this does is replaces the highlights in our first clip with the shadows from the second clip first, then replaces the shadows from the first clip with the highlights from the second clip. Let's try this out on two video clips. Add the cross dissolve transition, select it in the timeline, and in the inspector window, change the look to shadows. I'll also ripple trim this transition clip out a bit to highlight the effect. This is the original transition. And the same two clips with the shadows cross dissolve. Method 2 is very similar, except this time we'll change the look to highlights. This does the exact opposite of the last look, replacing the shadows first, then the highlights. Let's apply this to our next two video clips, change the look to highlights, and stretch it out to make it last a bit longer. Once again, here's the default cross dissolve, and the same two clips with the highlights cross dissolve transition. That was the easy way of achieving this effect, but not really a true Luma fade. For the next two methods, we'll use the actual Luma keyer, and as you'll see, the results will speak for themselves. But before we do, I want to take a minute to talk about the sponsor of this video, Envato Elements. Whether you edit videos for a living, or it's just a hobby, a subscription to Envato Elements can be a game changer. It's an all-in-one subscription service that gives you access to over 56 million digital assets. You get unlimited downloads of stock video, royalty-free music and sound effects, video templates, graphic templates, custom fonts, and so much more. And new items are added every week. Everything Envato Elements has to offer is included for one low monthly fee. This is super helpful if you're trying to grow your business or your YouTube channel and don't have an unlimited budget. Click the link in the video description and see how Envato Elements can help you make better videos. Now, back to Final Cut Pro. Place your playhead between your two clips and go back 1 or 2 seconds. Press Command B to play your clip and drag it straight up to place it above the timeline over the start of your second clip. Press Command 5 to open the effects browser, and from the keying category, select the Luma keyer. Drag and drop this effect over your top clip. With your playhead at the start of this clip in the inspector, drag the top Luma slider all the way to the left. Add a keyframe here. Press the down arrow to go to the end of this clip, and the back arrow key to go back one frame. Drag both the top and bottom Luma sliders all the way to the left. Your top clip should be completely transparent. What this does is fade out your highlights in your top clip first, followed by midtones and shadows for this cool Luma fade effect. And for our last example, instead of fading out our first clip, we'll use the Luma keyer to fade in our second clip. Place your playhead between your two clips and bring it back about 1 to 2 seconds. Grab your second clip and snap it to the playhead above your timeline. Move your playhead to the end of your first clip, and with the top clip selected, press Command B to blade it. Drag the second part of this clip down into your timeline and delete the gap clip. Move the playhead to the start of your top clip, select it, and add the Luma keyer effect. With your playhead at the start of this clip, drag the bottom slider all the way to the right and add a keyframe. Down arrow to move to the end of this clip, and back arrow to go back one frame. Grab the top slider and use it to move both control points all the way back to the left. The highlights in your top clip will fade in first, followed by midtones and shadows for this cool effect. You can also do this the opposite way and fade in your shadows first, followed by midtones and highlights. Let's select our top clip and reset our Luma slider parameter. Move your playhead to the start of this clip and before making any adjustments, select the invert checkbox. Grab your bottom slider and drag it all the way to the left to reveal your bottom clip. Add a keyframe. Move your playhead to the end of this clip and back one frame, and drag both the bottom and the top sliders back to the right. This makes your shadows fade in first, followed by midtones and highlights for the school effect. If you enjoyed this video, let me know by hitting the like button or in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.